on a Field of Dragons in time and use these windows. That's been missing for Unicorns of Love. I think if they fix that, or just pick some early game champions, like hop off the Tristana, play some Lucian, play some Corki, play something like that, maybe even Caitlyn, Unicorns can just have a different type of game come out for them.
And Millennium going back to the ban of the Orianna over the Kha'Zix, so they're going to first pick it themselves. And they have their red and blue side bans just hashed out already.
Yep. Always removing the Syndra, always removing the Jarvan. They let Orianna go through once, said, you know what, that was pretty scary from Power of Evil. But Unicorns of Love have just gone for these same three bans this time around. They could still get the Maokai, they could still get Gilius Lee Sin. But I think here you actually grab the Lucian away from Creatine, and you give Vardogs a champion he can win lane with.
I don't think that you pick the Lee Sin here because it's not contested because Kha'Zix is already on the field. You go with the Lucian, which is highly contested. Creatine has played that both games, and it is Vardag's most comfortable champion for him. At the same time, though, do you want something for Hillsang? Do you want to secure that Thresh? I don't think so.
No.
You go with the Lucian here.
There's nowhere for the Thresh there. J-Reed doesn't... Okay, J-Reed does play Thresh, to be fair, but like... He certainly doesn't care about it, right? The Nami's not that important. Thank you for clicking Lucian. That is, I think, the correct lock in here for Unicorns of Love.
Okay. They're going to leave Maokai up.
They'll leave Maokai up. Interesting.
Instead, they're going to wait to see what happens up in the top lane.
Well, you remember, they hovered on Maokai as a bait, I think. Remember, this is the guy who played Swain Top in a Maokai.
Yep.
So there's always the chance. So Nami does get picked up for what it's worth. Okay, showing that it is... Yeah, the same thing, right? Over and over and over again, J-Rig is going to play that some more. Created is going to go back to his token Ezreal, though, when he doesn't get Lucian.
Just another lane bully for him. Of course, Lucian excels a little bit more in that regard.
Yeah.
With the Nami by his side, Ezreal is extremely potent for all-ins.
Well, the thing is, Ezreal is he can all-in. I don't think he's... I wouldn't classify him personally as a lane bully. I would classify him as a champion where he's just very unique in team fights, right? He's the best poking AD carry, and that was actually a difficulty for Millennium. It was closing games out with the Siege. They've got a good AD carry for that. And the fact that Kerp can actually help these sort of mid-game team fight all-ins by putting True Shot Barrage through, I'd consider more like sort of like a Graves or something where like he's there for the mid-game caster potential and his safety overall in team fight, more than the laning phase.
I understand that.
Yeah, I don't think you classify champions as like hyper carries and lane bullies. There's a lot
There's
more
a little
like
gray area.
Barris as the Ezreals, right?
Yeah, we're just like lane bullies. It's like, ah, Lucian, Caitlyn,
yeah.
And then you go down Corki. And then
right, and that's fine to play those.
Eventually you get to Ezreal because he's not a hyper carry, but he has this place where he fits in, which is like caster AD.
He's very mid-gaming, and he's a very big caster AD carry. So Ahri does come back. The Power of Evil did not get the Orianna, just picks something.
Does leave Poppy up for Unicorns of Love in this case.
So here's the cool thing. Unicorns of Love's older jungler,
Sheepy,
he is now the coach of Unicorns of Love. And I got to run into him. You and I both ran into him earlier today. And I was like, so what's the deal with like your guys' strategy? You guys are playing really smart with wards and everything. And he's like, actually, it's mostly the players I'm helping, but my players are all really smart actually overall. I'm like, so what's the deal with all these weird picks like Swain Top? He's like, actually, Visichachi comes up with those. I do a lot of 1v1 lane tests with him. We test a lot of 1v1 matchups. And I tell him, no, this is working, go play it. But he's the guy who comes up with these. So I assume Sheepy signed off and said, yep, Poppy's the thing now. So guys, if you saw something that made you want to change your vote, might be Poppy, maybe. Send your tweet to @LOLEsports, use the hashtag MILWin, or come on, hashtag UOLWin. We'll see if you guys think Poppy's going to take the victory here in Game 3.
I was just told that this is the first time that Poppy has ever been played on the LCS stage competitively, ever.
Yep. Has been played during rehearsals, I'm pretty sure.
So here's the thing, is we did that feature on new champions. Poppy is definitely not a new champion, but you heard Trashy talk about it's more on the other people who don't know how to play against it. How do you react to that type of champion? You have to know what its damage output is and do damage assessment on something that you haven't played against before.
And the cool thing as well is whenever I see a Poppy, I always think, who is your best ult target? Because Diplomatic Immunity makes you immune to literally everything that any champion can do to you except the guy you target here. Mundo only has cleavers. Cotnex would not be able to kill him. And I mean, he has a slow, I guess. Creatine has no CC at all and probably couldn't kill him either. And Jayree, maybe you don't ult him because he has that CC sort of potential. So I want to see who Visichachi targets and see how much he can sort of ignore and who he can kill.
You go man mode and you just slam Creatine out of the fight. And then it's over.
Yeah.
Boop. Going after the Poppy.
Scarlet Hammer.
He's already has movement speed as his first.
W at level 1. It's fine. I think I don't know if he actually, like, Twitch leveled it because he was getting hit or what, but... So, fun fact. Scarlet Hammer Poppy is 100% play rate of all Poppy players on this stage.
It must be an extremely popular skin.
Yeah.
That or your sample size is way too small. It's got to be the former.
Hey, it's how you use the sample size, not how big it is.
Oh. I know exactly what's going on in this jungle here. Invisichachi, the fact that he's not going to have anything for that level one, except for some movement speed, and I guess some extra
armor and AD.
Armor. Doesn't have any hitting ability, so they're going to try to go for a lane swap here.
Poppy not exactly the best 1v2 also.
No.
We'll see how these lanes match up. So Millennium have a lot of trinket wards down in the northern jungle. They could reinvade. They see that no one is around to contest though. So Millennium could get a very safe buff steal. And the thing is, this is supposed to be UOL's strong side of the map. And that trinket ward timed out. Wow. Millennium are going to get this completely clean.
And the question is, does Unicorns of Love figure out what's going on in time that Gilius can go over to the enemy red buff and take it for himself and get a 2-buff start?
We got to see. Poppy walks to the bottom lane, sees no one is there, realizes 2v2 top. I think they can at this point assume bot lane is where you go next.
Oh, the W start for Power of Evil.
Yeah. Probably he's not getting much damage out of that, actually. He's also getting no push at all. So Kerpus being, honestly, untouched as he kind of shoves minions down. All right, Gilius does choose it right. Kevin does not try to stop that. It's fine. He's going to sit there in the 1v1. And I think actually Poppy can handle Mundo 1v1.
Yeah,
I think
he'll
get license to farm.
He has a ton of consumables right now. He's looking to just consume out of this lane and try to bully Kevin as much as he can. As crazy as it sounds, this Poppy is going to be slamming this Mundo a tiny bit.
So what's cool about this as well, Visichachi literally can never take full damage from one of Kevin's cleavers. It's actually impossible.
Creating on that Ezreal. Comfort picks coming out here for a lot of these players. Bardag's on his. Hillisong. Gilius. And then Kreatin, Jayri, and Kevin. Cotnex as well. He's wrapping around. Ooh. He avoided all wards in this duo lane in the top.
Well, we got to see, though. Nami's going to have to land some CC here. I don't think Kha'Zix can do it by himself. Bardag is injured. He doesn't chug his potion, though. He has no reason to not eat that thing. Get some health back, bro. That actually could really burn him here. 400 health is very killable. Even without Bubble. Bubble, ooh, gets Hillisong. Bardock says, yeah, I'll summoner heal you. Hook, nice by Hillisong to try to get away, but he might still go down. They trade blows, ignite on Cotnex. But that is three summoners down for UOL.
The hook saving Hillisong there, and then the flash afterwards. Good play by him to make the best of a bad situation. And now Gilius is going to try to go bully Cotnex in his jungle.
What a good trinket ward. The look at that by Cotnex to realize what was going on. Watches the root in. Gilius going to say, hey, you were here. And says, you know, you're actually at Tri-Brush right now. You have to be because of how the Wraith moved.
He's going to go take the Wolves now in return and do a little bit of counter jungling. At the same time, though.
He could actually sneak in. Oh, no, we saw him. Cotnex waited long enough. Said, you might come by here. Kerp is there for the flank.
Looking
he's
going
to get the Rune Prison. Good damage in. The Lantern's there. Hops to it. He's going to be safe. But good damage from Nami. Ignite is on. And Gilius gives up first blood and double buffs to Kerp.
The roam from Kerp, the Ghost, the Flash, using everything to secure double buffs for himself. And now Jayri taking a little bit of a hook there.
Really good play. The heal bounces around. Good dodge in the bubble as well. Creatives is back off my support.
Yep. Cotnex wrapping around top.
30 to 18 in CS, by the way. Millennium are absolutely dominating this bottom lane.
You know the Cotnex is here, but look at this. So much for the Unicorns of Love. People want the Poppy to work. They believe. But is it false hope? Oh, look at that. Beating up the Mundo. Counter pick confirmed. There's going to be a lot more Poppies today.
I believe it. Jungle Fizz, Poppy top, mid lane Talon.
Oh, Hillisong.
Gotta be careful.
Not
good damage trigger. He's definitely going to die here. Great bubble out of Vardox. Cotton getting some good damage down. 100 health. Gilius comes in. Summoner heal. Keeps him alive though. And here comes the Poppy. Can he get the slam? Yes, he gets the first kill. And wow, a double kill for Visichachi on Poppy. Doesn't get any more.
He just space jammed him. That was awesome. Oh, Kerp. After Power of Evil.
Good charm, though, dude. Power of Evil wins that trade pretty heavily.
But here comes
and
Gilead.
And suddenly a Lee Sin. Rune Prison doesn't matter. Ignite is on. That's a kill. Unicorns Ooh. Of Love finally get a good early game. 3-2 and kill.
They are back into this game. They don't have a lead, though. They equalized it off of what ended up happening top. They're down in summoner spells. But then, good play there, but a little over-aggression from Cotton X for Hillisun.
All right, suddenly Unicorns of Love, they can breathe a little bit, and maybe they can make this work. Also, by the way, Poppy is a crazy late-game terror. So I feel like any of the squishes on Millennium going to have some nightmares because fed Poppies are ludicrous.
I'm just glad it's not Lolly Poppy because that's even scarier for nightmares.
No, no, we've already established you have to play Scarlet Hammer.
It's the only way to go, I guess.
Yep. Ooh, statistically true. Man, look how fast he kills that golem.
He's almost six. He is so... Oh, this is good.
He's ready. He's got a Sheen.
Are we ready for this? He's gotten back into this lane. Oh, wow. The six coming out here. The TP from Vizichachi. Not being shut down this game. Not being camped by Cotton X. It's working out great for him. This new pick.
You know... Picking Poppy is illegal in some countries, but Vizichachi's got diplomatic immunity. He's in a foreign country, it works, guys.
He is actually. That's right. Welcome to LA.
It's not a country.
It's the city that we're in, Freak.
Actually, we're not.
No, that's true. It's the county.
Okay. We finally got there. It's like a country. Gilius comes in though. Nice Q gonna land that. Nice slows. Almost gets the wall slam. And Kevin will get to safety.
The level 6 came out for Kevin, so the gank is a little bit late there by Gilius. If he had gotten there when he was level 5, there was no chance he was making it out of that. He didn't even have to blow his flash there.
It's true, though. It's a little bit of a waste of time. Gilius, though, sending a message, certainly. Cotton X, ooh, look at this with the blue buff crap. He's only level 4, but is scaling up rather nicely off these buff steals.
And Gilius, at the same time, still has those double buffs swinging on him. Doesn't go for his red first. Instead,
he thinks he can get blue.
He's making a dip towards this blue. It's going to waste some of his time.
I think he saw Cotton X on board.
He just saw Cotton X walk back, so he knows exactly what's going on. They know the Power of Evil. They want to get him a blue, so they're going to go after the enemy blue now. And Kerp?
They have a ward, but Kerp goes around the ward. He's not going to get spotted.
Kerp's not going to go for this at
all. Okay.
His jungler, Cotton X, is doing the red, so there's no way that he's going to be around.
This is looking a lot better. Unicorns of Love making much better choices. Gold lead, very slight for them. Cotton X, red buff, level 6. Okay.
Here's the thing, though, is that Millennium... They have always had this early game lead, but we'll talk about that
hold
in a second
Creed
here.
Taking a whole bunch of damage. The land in. There's the True Shot Barrage, dodged away by Hillisong, and there's the kill for Vardux. Now on a Jayree, 400 health, forcing the flash. And here comes Cotton X, though. Goes in, double kill, though. It's going to be Cotton X trying to pick this up. He gets one. He goes in towards Hillisong. Takes a bunch of damage from the box, though. TP not up for Vizichachi, and Kevin's looks like his got canceled. And Hillisong's not going to win that fight. Kerp will get this kill, though. But here comes Power of Evil, not going to be enough.
They get the flash out of Kurt, Power of Evil pops his ultimate, and that teleport from Kevin was actually interrupted by Vizichachi.
Yep. So both bot lanes die, but a double kill all the same, I believe, for Vardux himself. I got my counting right. Kurt now taking some decent damage.
So here's the thing I wanted to talk about was Millennium, they've always had an early game lead versus Unicorns of Love based off of kills and Cotton X's map movements. But here's the thing, they've always managed to somehow let UOL get back into the game, which is huge. They just had an advantage there. They tried to push it too hard and in the incorrect way without proper vision, and they got collapsed on. And now Unicorns of Love are actually in the lead by like a tiny bit of gold.
And they're going to play Dragon for this one, actually.
And TP advantage is in favor of Vizichachi.
Yep. Kevin and Kerp can't get there. This has got to be Unicorns of Love's Dragon, unless there's a Miracle Steal from Cotton X.
He's not going to make it in time. Even if he leaps right now,
all right, there you go. One of the first dragons ever. I think this is like the second or third total dragon for Unicorns of Love in this series. But it puts him 1,000 gold up. And they've still got that late game insurance policy of the highest CS in the game, Poppy. How?
I don't even know, man. I don't even know why Poppy's picked right now.
Because she's awesome. What do you mean, why was Poppy picked?
Just don't do this to me.
She even uses Trinity Force. How could you not like this champion?
Whoa. I thought she's not going to get an Infinity Edge, though.
Actually, some do. I've seen a lot of Poppy builds.
You've seen a lot of Poppy in your days. Freak has seen some stuff.
There's a couple of low D1 Poppy mains. They are terrifying.
You run into them all the time.
A couple. This dude named Opened. He kills me a lot.
Yeah, I saw you play Aurelian in Italy. You do get killed a lot.
Yeah, I do. This is why I'm casting. I'm like double lift.
Whoa. Anyway. Oh, he can't even defend himself right now.
Sounds like his in-game play. Oh! It's a Chachi though, man. 83 CS on a Poppy. Kevin's got to be afraid of him.
And this minion wave is somehow pushing towards him too. And he's just like, yes, all this farm, even more. Remaining the highest CS member in the game.
This is something I'd always wondered when it was going to happen. You have champions like Dr. Mundo who are not bully laners, right? They sit there and farm. Why not play the worst laners in the world against him and just scale? Vizachachi's like, guys, it's a license to play Poppy. I can't lose lane. It's impossible.
Yeah, that is really true. And the fact that they got him that counter pick on red side.
Bam! Oh! Half health on Kevin from one combo.
It's a my green ward.
Yep. So by the way, Poppy build, max Q, maxing W second. Only 1 point in the charge. Is going for Triforce first, Sheen, then Phage. For what it's worth, actually, I think Poppy's really heavily magic damage dependent until she gets more items. Because while she actually has decent auto attacks later on in the game, her Q converts her entire damage into magic damage, even if it's like a Triforce where it's normally physical damage proc. So you're very magic damage heavy. You often see Deathfire Grasp and Sork Shoes on Poppy because
whoa,
of that.
Whoa, what?
You sometimes see DFG, Sork Shoes, Triforce, or Lich Bane.
Please no. This just sounds like a nightmare.
It exists. You like one-shot people with magic damage.
You often see this build on Poppy.
And relative to seeing Poppy.
Okay, there we go. Thank you. If I see one Poppy player do it, it's got to be the most popular Poppy build.
It's like
build.
Scarlet Hammer Poppy, dude, 100%.
He hasn't done it just yet.
He's clearly very good at killing golems.
Yeah. The fact that his Q has so many things that go into it, it's got like an AP and AD ratio, a flat health portion of, or flat damage portion of it. Then it has a percent HP damage portion on it on top of it.
Yep.
So it's like four sources all just like whoop into one skill.
It's a lot of damage.
Especially against Mundo. I'd be very interested to see what his damage is like at the end of this game.
You know what's ironic actually? Because of her passive being like, if you take more than 10% of your current health and damage, it gets cut by half. Talon's Q is actually really effective against her because it's like a long bleed, which is Noxian Diplomacy. So apparently her diplomatic immunity doesn't work against Noxian Diplomacy. The more you know. Ability puns I've never had the chance to use before. All right. 1700 gold lead, Millennium are trying to squeak back in. Of course, they're up 2-0 in this best of five. And Unicorns of Love maybe making their comeback here. If they finally got that early game lead, they're actually stretching that gold lead as well. They are up a turret kill. Their bot lane made it happen. Creighton's early game CS lead, that was 31-18. That's been closed now. Vardox is equal again in CS. iEdge and Trinity Force both done. Curb hooked in. Charm lands into the box. Nice ignite as well. Do they have the damage though? He's going to walk back. Just going to survive.
UOL, Power of Evil, did not use his ignite or his ultimate there.
Oh man. If Curb stays.
They had kill potential on Curb.
Well, Hillsong used his ignite though. Yeah,
still,
the ulti
initial
chase,
damage.
The ulti chase might have worked.
Yes.
To be completely fair. Ult in, flash away with ignite on. I think you're totally right about that one. Mid lane is going to go down though. The pressure they put in was enough. Good rotation by UOL. And now looks like top lane going to be the focus of attention.
Kevin's going to have to book it out of there because he's going to have to sacrifice that turret. The rest of Millennium are not even close. They're going to cut him off in the lane.
All right, Hillsong flays him in. Hook.
Oh!
He just mad life that poor guy. Kevin's going to go down. The ulti that Power of Evil saved. Ha, Zyrene is going to let them get the kill. And down goes top lane outer turret.
Why'd you just laugh at me?
Because you're like, oh, if he ulted, he would have killed Kurt, bro.
Oh.
I'm just messing with you. I'm sorry. Poppy's got me all like hyped up about making fun of things now. I just can't help it.
Yeah, he's actually running hybrid penetration in his reds.
Mm.
And he's running HP regen in his quints so that he can stay in the lane.
Makes sense.
Started with flask and three potions. So that regardless of what lane he got, he's going to be pretty decent at staying alive and getting the CS that he needs to be in that late game.
All right, yeah. Just sucks it up and kills minions no matter what damage it deals to him.
This is so good. The play into the hook after the flash. So good.
So good. And Power People got the kill. Deathfire, Grasp, Void Staff is going to be his build here.
Here's the ward control from UOL and the positional advantage on this dragon. They don't even have a mid turret tier 1 to give up at this point. So this dragon is practically theirs. They just need Visichachi to show up. Yeah.
Thanks, Santorin. It's like listen to the cast, bro. Kevin charmed up, though. This is not good for him. A lot of damage, and there comes Poppy. He ults Kevin, doesn't care. Goes for Jayri. Half health on the Nami. 1-0 so far. Nice knockback. Jayri in the air.
What are you
and
doing?
Down he goes. Visichachi gets a double kill. Down goes Cotton X, but Kerp is on a rampage. Finds one. Goes for Gilius. Bit of damage there. Neo, he's cut off. Oh, Creighton flashes in.
Oh.
The Q hit. Nice pickup there. A 3-2 so far in Unicorn's favor. Kerp could maybe get out. Visichachi.
I don't know. Swiggity swooty, Visichachi's coming for it.
Oh, flat on the wall. Kerp does not have flash. That's going to be the kill. Gilius steals it from Visichachi.
Visichachi was known as the Swain player. He's pretty much the Poppy player now because he was the only Poppy player in the LCS.
Yep. 4-0-1 on Poppy. So they did fight. They turned off Dragon.
TP.
Kevin wants to contest this. Of course, there's low health bars in Unicorn.
Tons of pink wards here from Unicorns of Love. Low health bars, like you said, they haven't been back to buy.
1,400 gold on Poppy. She has teleport. So we'll see what the build ends up being. I have no idea.
Oh, to the face!
Could be Cutlass.
Boots Cutlass.
Yes! All right. Sorry, I feel really excited that I knew that. So the thing is, I don't know if it's Gunblade or Blade of the Rune King. Both are totally viable on Poppy. The more you know.
Time of viable Poppy builds. 2014. How is this 2014?
Almost every item in the game is viable on Poppy.
Sure, this isn't like 2010.
Whatever, dude. That's great. Name an item. I'll bet you it works on Poppy.
Ohm Wrecker.
Execution calling. Ohm Wrecker. Both viable because
I don't know,
her passive doesn't work on turret. So Ohm Wrecker, make sure she can turret dive.
Frost Queen's claim.
Extra slow or CC.
You're just naming what the items do.
Great.
Visichachi, 4-0-1 on this Poppy, and you can't help but think, you know, it's probably not gonna be banned next game because because it's red side. It was red side counterpick.
Oh, true. Kevin just won't pick Mundo.
Yeah, he would stray away from that into something else.
So yeah, if he knew like Darius or Aurelia would do great there in that matchup, I think Aatrox as well, all things in his pool. So, yeah, things to keep in mind. Visichachi going to make his way back up. He's looking for the flank play. This is good. And Unicorns of Love.
Waddling through.
3,000 gold down. Visichachi goes in. Kerp, though, gets exploded. Fardugs gets the kill. Kevin also in a really bad spot. Millennium not playing with a deficit well at all.
Unicorns of Love play much better with a deficit than Millennium do. And now the Unicorns of Love have an advantage. They are pushing it so hard against Millennium. Back when Unicorns of Love was down about 5k, it looked like they were even.
Yeah.
Now when they're up 5k, it looks like they're up 10.
And they're just massively blowing people up. Visichachi's zoning people out with his body. Mid lane turret goes down 4-2 in turrets, 12-6 in kills. Unicorns of Love just turned it on this game, finally.
And they're going to go straight for this dragon after that play. And they're going to pick up even more gold for themselves. Their vision control is impeccable across the map around the objectives that they set up for. And it's really funny because when we...
Oh, God. Oh, he's been revealed by that little lizard guy. Creighton knows.
Eh.
He has to know.
Eh.
Steal it!
Surprise!
Oh, into the wall! Oh my god, Creighton! Jeez! Why'd you stand by a wall? You know someone's there. Dragon goes to Unicorns of Love. They are up 6,000 gold 20 minutes in. Kripp's got a blue buff. He's going for, yeah, some early magic resist, yeah.
It'll help against the Poppy a tiny bit. That Poppy, he's even with highest CS in the game right now.
Dude.
Too good.
Props.
It's too good. Ghost Poppy, he's
so
just gonna
many
run.
Props.
It's funny too, because Poppy's this champion that people make like highlight reels of where it's Poppy like 1v5ing because of the passive.
Right.
But you never see it in competitive play because its laning phase is just so hard to get through.
Mm-hmm.
But if you pick it into something like a Mundo, you have no problem there. So UOL, every time they're up against a wall, Visichachi's like, I got this pocket pick. It's like people are like, Maokai, 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 Maokai. He's like, pick it. I got Swain. And then Kevin's like, okay, we ditched the Maokai. Mundo, Mundo, Mundo. Mm-hmm. And he counterpicks with a Poppy. Because he hovered over the Maokai at the start, and he was like, I kind of want... No. Scratch that. I'm pretty sure that champion select took so long because he's sitting there going, no, I'm going to pick Poppy this game. His team's like, no, it's game three. We could lose.
No, he's like, yeah, that's the point.
Trust me, Poppy.
Play Poppy.
Poppy. What do we have to lose? We lose the game? Okay.
Yeah. Standard wasn't working. You heard the video about it, right? Double have said it. If you're going to get outplayed in a standard play, play something different. Yeah. That's the case. So, furthering the point, all six boot options are good on Poppy. Visit chat, she goes for swiftest boots. They all have a place. I'm not even kidding. Also, distortion boots for the extra TP power, so he's going to be all over the place.
And ghost.
Yeah, his ghost is going to be faster and on a really short cooldown.
He's so fast.
Zoom, zoom.
He's going bottom lane. The split push, Poppy Terror, two levels up over Kevin.
Look at that.
What?
Yeah, that's how much health he deals.
He crit him.
I don't even know if he did.
He crit him.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure he crit him there.
Did you see the text? I didn't.
Yeah, I think it was a small text, but okay. He crit him.
All right, I trust you.
I'm happy.
Was it Scarlet text? Were there Scarlet letters?
He's not committing adultery, please.
Also, their numbers, duh. Siege, top lane, Unicorns of Love, 6,000 gold lead. And of course, they have Lucian Ahri here. This actually is a decent Siege team.
This is way too funny. Vizachachi's just like, I'm going to split push bottom.
Oh, contact in the box, the charm. Down he goes. Kerpen out of fire back. Bardock loses a whole bunch of health, but he's going to stay alive. Ilias taking some damage. Kerp is still pretty farmed.
They have all the options.
The charm as well.
There's the TP.
And here comes Poppy. Down goes Kerp. And there's the knockback. Goodbye, Creatine. Double kill for Bardock.
Look at how fast he is. He's still. Oh, he goes straight for the turret.
Doesn't even take damage, dude.
Vroom.
Baron in the sights of Poppy.
Why does Poppy just look so scary right now? Usually you're just like,
she always does.
No, she doesn't usually look scary.
Does.
No, she does not usually look scary.
You're just like, this Poppy is, man.
And then,
no.
I haven't played against Poppy Terrors.
Pop, like, you know how everyone thinks like Teemo is Satan, even though Teemo's amazing? Poppy is actual Satan.
You're an AD carry main, so I'm pretty sure you know the wrath of any Poppy.
I'd rather play against Zed.
Oh, man. Bardock just gets so many shields and lives through the burst. He heals himself, too. And then the hook on the Kerp.
God, so good.
And then he starts walking forward because of the charm, and he's just completely blown up here. The kickback from Gilius onto Creatine sets up Vizachachi's heroic charge.
Mm-hmm. That was pretty glorious. Arcane Shift didn't save him. Brush didn't matter. Kill picked up. Now, good split by Kevin does take down bottom outer turret. Millennium are only down one turret here. They're actually keeping the objective somewhat in control, much like Unicorns was when they were behind. The problem is Unicorns are just winning fights so strongly. We've never seen a kill disparity this big before.
I don't think we've seen a lead this big at this point in the game, 24-minute mark, because the games have been going around 40 minutes.
Yeah.
Both game one and two were around that mark. And the team didn't start to pull away. It was back and forth until about 30 minutes, and then team was just like, okay, we're busting out of the gate here because the other team UOL just kept making bad moves or slightly bad mistakes. And now UOL are like, all right, we're going to cover ourselves. We're going to keep pushing turrets. We're going to use this Poppy. Vizachachi had a level advantage in that he was pushing it, and they played it perfectly. And it is Blade of the Rune King is what it looks like.
All right, yep. Attack speed added to the build. And here we go. Kerp going to take a Q to the face. Vizachachi goes in for it.
Time.
Looks at Creatine. Creatine's like, I'm sorry, please.
And he smacks him.
Out he goes. Turret goes down. Kevin gets flayed in. Gilius, though, is going to die. 1-0 for the trade back onto Ryze. That is a big loss. That Kerp is dead. In they go for Kevin. He's going to lose some health. Crew, man. Cotnex goes down. 2-1. Unicorns of Love now inside the base.
They get that turret, and they're going to get this inhibitor off the back of it. We might be looking at 100% win rate Poppy in the LCS.
In competitive play, certainly. Does Promoter Mechanus in the LCS? I actually don't know.
It's part of the promotion tournament.
Yeah.
If you look behind the players, there's things that would say European Championship Series.
No.
Between the games.
Oh, okay. Between the games. Because I see there's like monoliths with champions on them.
Yeah, no, those are really cool too.
Yeah, that's true.
It's probably pretty sure this is brought to you by the LCS.
Yeah.
Otherwise, we have to get this studio back.
Well, Kevin. Oh, ooh, good enough flash by Jerry. Stay safe. gets a wave of the Chachis in the mix, and they're saying, you know what, that's a red buff, no big deal. Grabs that, goes to Vardox here.
Yeah, they just don't let up. Unicorns of Love were pretty good at getting objectives when behind. When they are ahead, getting objectives is just that much easier for a team in general, and they do it so well.
Absolutely they do. And with the gold lead, they manage to make the right choices here. It's just when they're behind, they seem... Zoom! Well,
body
three
sex.
Correct answers. So just farm for Millennium. All they can do is sit in the base, hope to defend, and do what they can to farm back up. But they are down 10,000 gold. They've got a dead inhibitor as well. Now, they have a whole bunch of late game, though, right?
Yes.
They've got this Kha'Zix jungle. They've got a Mundo who will get tanky forever, and a Ryze who has still got room to scale. The problem is they're just being pressed so hard into their base. 26 minutes in, dead Baron, dead inhibitor.
Is he going to get red?
Yep.
It's going to get red. Blade of the Ruin King completed. Smack, 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 smack. And it's gone.
Hex Drinker's next.
That's what it looks like.
Viable item. I'm just going to say that no matter what he does. It doesn't even matter at this point. I'm just trolling you with it.
Everything he buys is a viable item. Rylai's Crystal Scepter.
His Q's going to slow. And his charge will too. More AP for his Q damage.
Isn't that what the item just does in general?
Yeah.
You're just gonna name what the item does because Poppy does everything.
However,
he's going ham.
Oh god, and he goes! And goodbye, Jayree! You are a dead Nami. Vardox gets the kill. Andrew's caught next, and down he goes as well. 2-0, Creighton forced to run. Good flash away. But Visichachi, the Terror, Blade of the Ruin King, use Creighton, helps him under heals. He's gonna get away, but by the way, a kill did come through for Kevin. 3-1 in this battle. Power people now stuck in the base.
They're going to go straight for the Indian
Yeah, they're going to go for this one. They've got some minions. It's only two members alive for Millennium. Gilius, isolated by Kurt, but Zachachi goes in, gets the shield. There's the slow. There's the jump. Gets him on the turret residue. Just barely. If Zachachi 6-0-6 is dominating, this could be the game. Unicorns of Love going to take their second inhibitor kill.
They're low on their HP bars. We're about to have Cotnex back up alongside Kevin. They're going to have to back off of this, but they have two inhibitors down. And they actually ping towards the Baron. It's not up for another 2 minutes. They're clearing the ward. Somebody's on ward duty.
Well, Millennium just back in the same kind of same place over and over again. I mean, Millennium was always a team that in this series was winning off of their great early games, good individual skill, and just setting up for dragons.
Yeah, and Cotnex 2-5-5. And he has great kill participation. Really, really high, 7 out of 8, but at the same time, didn't set up the right lanes. And look at Visichachi. Like, we can't talk about this game without talking about Visichachi. 6-0-6, slams Jayree against the inhibitor, takes him out, doesn't get knocked up, and then goes straight after Cotnex, and then he chases Creighton out of the fight. Vardax is left by himself here to deal with Kevin and Kerp.
Rune Prison in turret range.
So everybody was tunneling the back line, because that's the thing with Poppy, is you just don't give a damn about the front line.
Well, that's the cool thing as well, is that she's such a good siege breaker. Because you ult someone and then die of the AD carry, he has to leave turret range. Suddenly your team can push without their damage threat around.
Yeah. And a big part of this comp from Millennium is Creighton at the moment. Because Kerp, he's 3-6-2. His CS is okay, but it's about 100 less than where it should be at the 30-minute mark.
Yeah.
If he was actually on a farming champion. But he's been shut down. You can almost ignore him. He's going to go after somebody else. He's not going to try to chase the Poppy. The Poppy will be immune anyway, and they're going to go!
Jayree gets hit up, and down he goes. 1-0. Gilius is stuck. Finally gets the Lantern after a kick onto the Mundo.
Where's the Visichachi going?
Goes in, finds Kerp. Kerp did get the kill of Power of Evil, but by the way, Poppy is going to kill you, but they might trade back on the AD carry. Vardox, no, he stays alive. Creighton Visichachi again in the mix, and down he goes! Wow, the Poppy damage is massive. Takes the Lantern in. Kevin, now the only guy alive. He is going to fall down. The A's for Unicorns of Love. The 8-0-7 Poppy from Visichachi, undefeated. Unicorns of Love pull it into game 4, and they keep their hopes of the LCS alive.
Off the back of a champion that has not seen competitive play, Visichachi's Poppy. I don't even know what to say about that. That was a turret diving monster. The rest of the team had such a great game too off the back of it. They got the objectives that they needed in the early game.